What's up, guys? Sahow Man back with another figure review. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Living Dead dolls. This is my second one that I've ever, you know, purchased from the Living Dead dolls. I did pick up a Sam from Trick or Treat. You guys can watch my older videos, and I do plan on picking up the Pennywise one. But this is a 10-inch doll of Regan from The Exorcist. Now, if you guys have not watched the movie The Exorcist or seen the movie, it is, to me, my all-time scariest movie I have ever seen. Now, the movie was based, it's supposedly based on, you know, true events. Came out back in 1973. It's the scariest movie I've ever seen, guys. If you guys haven't watched it, definitely check the movie out. I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys have. It's about, you know, obviously possession and the Ouija board, but you know, I'm not gonna give into any spoilers, but this is really cool to have. So we'll get into the packaging right here. You got the big open window where you can see Regan, and then you got the Living Dead dolls right here, and then you have the iconic, you know, poster right here. You have the priest right over here, and then you come to the back. There is a little bit of a read-up, so you guys can read the description right there. Feel free to pause if you want to read it. And then you have Regan right here with the head turning around, which is awesome. On this side of the packaging, we have the Living Dead dolls, and then right over here it says Living Dead dolls, and you got some skulls here. Now, this is made by Mezco Toys, so that's it for the packaging. Let's go ahead and open this up and take a close look at Regan. Now, she doesn't come with any accessories, but she's got the really cool insert right here of the window in her bedroom. If you guys have seen the movie, you guys know all about this window, but that's a really cool little, you know, extra piece you can have for photos. But yeah, you get that little insert right there. Boo! And there you have Regan, guys. This is so nice. Now, a thing that I notice about the figure, the hair kind of comes off, so just be careful you don't mess with the hair a little bit too much, because some of it seemed to be kind of shedding off. But this is actually really nice. I mean, this is, you know, whether you like it or not, this is a doll, but it's a horror doll, but this is really cool. The hair looks, you know, it kind of looks a little bit real, you know, if you mess with it and if you look at it at a certain angle, but the hair on this is really nice. Now, the head sculpt is awesome. She's got the, you know, the scary looking face, the black around the eyes, the yellow eyes. She's got her little scars right here, which is all sculpted. It's not just painted. And then she's got a little bit of like maybe vomit or mucus that's coming down her nose, and a little bit right there in the chin, but she does have a lot of scars. Even in the ear, you can see a little bit of black right there. So she does have a lot of, you know, attention to detail. She's got a big old gash right there on the top of the forehead, but that is one scary looking head sculpt. The outfit is pretty nice too. I think it would have been awesome if they'd given us a little bit of vomit or something on there. It's a cloth material, obviously, but you can see the little designs. It's pretty movie accurate. So you can see that right there. You got some little buttons, you got the collar here, then you have her hands, her little hands. And then right here, if you wanted to, you can take off her nightgown. It's got, you know, the Velcro right over here. That's if you really want to. And then there's the bottom of the nightgown right here. So you got the little design going all the way through here, which is cool. You come down to the lower legs, and obviously her skin is kind of pale, and you can see little like black marks or bruises. And then she's got, now this blood marks, the blood marks right here are painted on. So you can see that right there. And then she's got some more over here. There's the bottom of the feet. Now, she is wearing underwear, because there's something I want to show you. A nice little touch that they added is the Help Me right there. Look how dope that is. I was wondering when I got this in package if they were going to add this. So yeah, she does have the Help Me right there, which on the stomach, it's so freaking nice. I love that attention to detail. So she does have that in case any of you guys are wondering. I don't think there's anything really in the back. Well, it's got the maiden, you know, Living Dead dolls and everything made in China right there on the back. But this is a nice figure, guys. Now, in the way of her articulation, the arms can go in and out, forward and back. You see that right there. The legs just have like a swivel to them. And nothing, I don't think there's any articulation at the waist or anything. And of course, the head can rotate. So you can recreate that iconic scene right here. You have her turning this way, and then just get the head to kind of turn around all the way. That's, you know, just like in the movie. That's freaking dope. Now, the head can, you know, tilt, and it also goes up and down. I saw in images, you know, if you wanted to recreate the stair scene where she's going down the stairs, and I guess you kind of can. You can put her body and you can position it back, and I guess depending on where you angle it, on how you angle it, you can recreate her, you know, going down the stairway, which is pretty cool. And there you have it, guys. This is my review. Today we're taking a look at the Living Dead Dolls Presents the Exorcist Regan action figure. Now this is recommended for ages 17 and up. This is made by Mezco Toys. It's a 10-inch doll. Highly recommend it if you're a horror fan or a fan of The Exorcist. Again, this is my all-time favorite, you know, scary movie. What is your all-time favorite scary movie? Comment below. If you guys want to see more Living Dead Doll reviews, hit the thumbs up button and let me know in the, you know, comments below what else you want to review, because I've already reviewed the Sam from Trick or Treat. I'm going to review the Pennywise. I think there's an Ash one coming out. There's a Dawn of the Dead one, or Day of the Dead one, I'm sorry. Or is it Dawn of the Dead? It's one or the other. But you guys let me know in the comments below what you guys think about this figure. Give the video a thumbs up. Stay tuned, because in Halloween, we're going to be reviewing horror figures all month. Thanks for watching, guys. This is kind of like a little tease for that. But we'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching. Peace.